Hey, what's up everyone? So Miui 12 on Oneplus 6 and 60. Yeah, well, in case you are bored with OxygenOS on your device, feel free to try this. By the way, in case you forgot my name, this is your host Manik and I'm back with the review of another custom ROM for Oneplus 6 and 60. And this time, it's Miui 12. And that too at a time when not even all Xiaomi devices have got this update. Well, I've been testing it out thoroughly since the past couple of days or so, as I wanted to be sure if it is stable enough to be used as a daily driver. So in this video, let's have an in-depth look at Miui 12 on Oneplus 6 and 60. And yes, the instructions to flash this ROM is at the end of this video. So let's get started. And one more thing, don't forget to click on that subscribe button and press the bell icon too, if you wish to stay notified about the latest videos from this channel. Yeah, well, some of you would argue and say, why do we need Miui on a device that was practically bloatware free? Well, the answer is simple, a refreshing experience, be it for a couple of days, because that is the only motive to flash a custom ROM. Anyways, the UI here is quite smooth and stable, and you can apply those live wallpapers from Miui 12 and custom icon packs as well. And you do get this new control center, which is a straight ripoff of iOS, but it looks good and is really built with usability in mind. And same for these volume controls too. And you can change this -1 screen to Google feed. So relax. Now in settings, let's move on to the always on display, my all time favorite. Well, you must have seen this in other rooms, and almost every room has it now. But literally, none of them provides a ton of themes inbuilt like this one has, and they all look great. If you don't like all these, you can download more or even create one. Everything can be customized and you control it. Plus it also has that horizon light feature, that too with some other animations and add-ons. One more thing I really like is this charging animation, and there are three options to choose from. One thing to keep in mind is that the notification LED just does not work right now with this port. In display settings, you will get options to customize the display colors, saturation, as well as the option to turn on DC dimming. And you can control dark mode too, because in Miui 12, it is forced to every app, so you can disable it for those apps that look weird. Apart from that, you can turn that control center off and switch over to Miui 11 type of notification panel. And those notch settings work just fine, and even better than OxygenOS 10, because it does not bring the whole status bar down and gives you the option to do that if you wish to. By the way, Miui 12 also has this type of floating windows for notifications and general multitasking, and you can edit this to add your favorite apps too. So you can make an app float over the top of any other and use two apps side by side, which is great for multitasking. In security settings, the fingerprint scanner option is there and it works, but only for Oneplus 6 and not on Oneplus 60. And that face unlock too does not work as of now. The fingerprint scanner is fast and even more responsive than it was on OxygenOS 10. Seriously, I don't know how, but it is what it is. And if you were concerned about your data and privacy, well, Miui has some good options. Like it manages a history of apps that access your camera, mic or location, and it denies them whenever it is asked for in the background. So you can see all of that here. The battery stats page has also been redesigned in Miui 12, and it looks great and clear. The graph here is quite intuitive and the data can be broken down and seen clearly, so that's great. And you do get features like second space and dual apps with this one. So you can use multiple accounts for WhatsApp, Instagram, etc. as you currently do with OxygenOS. There is also a screen time feature that is alternative to digital well-being that we have with Chalk Android, and it keeps a check of the time you are spending on each app and can be used to control your smartphone addiction with the help of that focus mode, which is a copy of Zen mode in OxygenOS. So it has everything cloned off from every Android skin, but these are all good features. Apart from this, there are some neat features like built-in backup and restore tool, a cool looking storage space, and the way it categorizes all the space consumed, it just looks cool. Plus there is also a cool looking dynamic weather app, a new Wi-Fi details page, and this bedtime mode and clock. And there are other tiny features too that I will leave it up to you to explore, and most of them work just fine. One thing to keep in mind is that there is no camera app inbuilt, so make sure you install a Gcam mod from here. Now moving on to the final aspect, battery life and gaming performance on this one. So I did test quite a bit of games on it, and I did play some PUBG sessions too, and I faced no issues whatsoever. The heat up was a bit on the higher side, and the battery life isn't the best out there, but manageable, if you don't use your device extensively. And I did manage close to 5 hours of screen on time with medium usage. So overall, you will feel good after trying this one, as it is quite functional and refreshing at the same time. If stock Android is not your cup of tea, and huge thanks to the developers for this one, and you can support them using link in description area. And that was it for features. Now let's see how to flash this one. So first of all, make sure the bootloader of your device is unlocked. And after that, download the zip file from link in description area and make sure you are on Oxygen OS 10. Now unzip the downloaded file and connect your phone in fast boot mode to your PC. And you can do that by long pressing on the power key and volume key at the same time. So after connecting it to PC, open the folder you extracted. Double click on the file ending with flashallwipe.bat and wait for the next 5 to 7 minutes till your device restarts, and ignore any error you see on the screen. It's nothing. And if your device does not boot up after like 10 or 15 minutes, go back to the recovery mode and format the data. This will help you out. So that's it. Now you are done. So now you are done, and I've rebooted to the latest Miui 12 port from Oneplus 6 and 60. So let me know your experience in the comment section down below. And do like this video if it helps you out. And don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. And I'll see you guys in the next one.